Okay, once again, good morning to all. Today we are going to start the unit number 2. The name of the unit is Introduction to the Kernel and Buffer Cache. Okay. So without wasting any time, let me show you the actual content of this unit are here. That is what we are going to learn under this unit. So you can see the architecture of the Unix operating system is the first topic. Introduction to the system concept, kernel data structure, system administration, buffer cache, buffer header, structure of buffer pool, reading and writing disk block, and a case study where we are going to learn the booting and the shutdown, scripting and shell. Okay, so under this case study, booting, bootstrapping, booting the PCs, grub, booting with single user mode, booting, rebooting and shutting down, shell basic, bash scripting, Python scripting, scripting best practice, working with startup scripts. So these are under the shell script where actually we already started the shell basics, bash scripting, and we also know the scripting best practices and working with the startup script. So this already you are having a hands-on sessions in the practical hours where you can learn all these things with respect to shell script. So a basic intention of the case study is to make you familiar, and your job is also important, that you should take a very keen interest in learning and understanding this case study. Because all case study, it's difficult to complete in a classroom. So it's one of the idea behind this case study is that a student should actually take an interest by their own to learn and understand this case study. No doubt that a faculty support will always be there. I will also cover these things theoretically and practically in the classroom and in practical room also. Okay, so these are the content of your unit number two, where you can see the very first article is architecture of the Unix systems. Now a question can come in your mind that, sir, already in the unit number one we have seen the architecture of the Unix operating system. Yes or no? So my dear student, that architecture of the Unix system, that is nothing but the layer architecture where hardware layer, kernel layer, then the system call and command level, and last one is the other application program, that is user level. That layered architecture we already discussed in unit number one. Then what we are going to learn under this first point, that is architecture of the Unix system. What happened? Let me give you the brief idea of what we have seen in the last unit. In the unit number one, it gave a high level perspective of the Unix system environment. Okay. So high level perspective means क्लासरूम में भी मैंने कहा था कि वॉट इज द यूजर परसेप्शन टुवर्ड्स यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, दैट इज अ हाई लेवल परस्पेक्टिव. सो यूजर इज लुकिंग टुवर्ड्स द यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द फाइल सिस्टम, विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द प्रोसेसिंग एनवायरमेंट, एंड विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द बेसिक बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक. सो दीज आर द थ्री हाई लेवल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, और यू कैन कॉल इट एज अ हाई लेवल परस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. Okay, now I hope that everybody is clear with the file system, everybody is clear with the processing environment, and everybody is also clear with the basic building block. Yes or no? 53 students are here. Okay, so if anybody is having doubts in file system, processing environment, and the building blocks, he or she can at any time can come to me and clear their doubts. Okay, but that high level perspective is a very important topic in unit number 1. Now we will turn towards unit number 2, that is our current unit. So in this unit we are going to focus on kernel. Okay, so dear student, underline the sentence. We are going to focus on the kernel, and we are going to providing an environment or overview of its architecture and outlining the basic concepts and the structures essential for understanding the rest of the topics in this OSA. Okay, this is very important. Whatever I am saying in the beginning of this unit number 2, that we are going to focus on the kernel. अभी तक आपने देखा है कि इन यूनिट नंबर 1 आई यूज द वर्ड कर्नल वन और इन वन और टू आर्टिकल वेयर आल्सो वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द कर्नल एंड द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ओके एंड व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल सर्विसेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द कर्नल ओके कैन एनीबडी टेल मी व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल सर्विसेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द कर्नल व्हाट आर द सर्विसेज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द कर्नल Anybody can unmute without typing in the chat box. You can unmute yourself and you can share your thoughts about services provided by kernel. What are the services provided by the kernel? Because now see, entirely we are focusing on the kernel in this unit. But before that, you should know what is the services provided by the kernel and what is kernel. Yes, anybody can unmute and can give the idea about kernel. Yes. Anybody? Chetan, if you are there, you can unmute and you can share your thoughts about kernel. What is kernel?
So it is interface between hardware and applications.
Yes. That is the interface between the hardware and the application. Any other? Avinash? Avinash Mendre.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What is a kernel? What is kernel? Any other? No, we are not able to listen properly from Avinash. Yes. Any other? What is the services provided by the kernel? Okay, what is happening? Yes. Prathamesh. Management task. Arjun is saying that I always resides in main memory and file system maintenance. See, dear student, आपने अभी तक स्टडी चालू नहीं किया शायद. You have not started your what you can say the study, self study is not started. Okay, very important that you should start the self understanding so that you can get all these things.
very important. Engineering student must start self-study immediately after the class is over or immediately after the topic is completed. Now see, for that reason, now what you can see on your screen, okay, on your screen you can notice that I have shared. Number one, okay, there, this is that architecture of the Unix, okay, layered architecture. We will take some time, 2 to 3 minutes for this kernel, and then we will again come back to unit number two, okay. So, you are familiar with this architecture of the Unix. This is the user's perspective, file system, processing environment, building blocks. The file system. Okay. This is the processing environment. This is building blocks. Operating system services and assumption about hardware. So here you can see on the screen, there are services provided by the kernel. So many times I said that kernel and operating systems are one and same. They are not two different entities. They are one and same. Kernel is the operating system itself. So the services provided by the kernel are actually the services provided by the operating system. So you can see there on your screen, controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, or suspension and communication. So kernel kya karega? Kernel controlling the execution of the process by allowing their creation, termination, suspension and communication. Second, you can read there, scheduling the processes fairly for execution of the CPU. So scheduling of the processes, there is a time shared manner and all these things are there, okay, but it schedules the process fairly for execution of the process of execution of the CPU. Then allocating the main memory for executing process. This is the third service provided by the kernel. Allocating the main memory for an executing a process. Then allocating the secondary memory for efficient storage and retrieval of the user data. And lastly, allowing the process controlled access to peripheral devices such as terminal, tape, disk, drive, and networking devices, and many more. So these are basically the services provided by the kernel. Okay, as I said that kernel and the operating systems are one and same. And then you can see on the next section where when you come across the kernel. So here the kernel topics again we discussed in the unit number one. What is the OS? Operating system is a collection of a software that manages the computer hardware resources and acts as an interface between user and hardware of the computer. Okay, it provides a common services for computer program. The OS is a crucial component of the system software in computer system. Okay, this is a in general meaning of the operating system. So that is the interface. So the main goal of this definition or this paragraph number one is that it is a interface between the user and the hardware. Now below you can read the kernel. Sorry. Kernel is a core part of the operating system and responsible for all major activities of this operating system. Okay. So dear student, kindly make an underline. Aapko ye abhi malum chahiye. Aapne एक इमीडिएटली आंसर देना चाहिए था मुझे कि व्हाट इज द सर्विस प्रोवाइडेड बाय द कर्नल. व्हाट इज द कर्नल? सो कर्नल इज अ कोर पार्ट ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर ऑल मेजर एक्टिविटीज ऑफ दिस ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. नेक्स्ट यू कैन रीड, कर्नल कंसिस्ट ऑफ द वेरियस मॉड्यूल्स एंड इट इंटरैक्ट्स डायरेक्टली विद लो लेवल हार्डवेयर. इट ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड्स द रिक्वायर्ड एब्स्ट्रैक्शन टू हाइड द लो लेवल हार्डवेयर डिटेल्स to the system or application programs. An operating system is unable to run without kernel as it is an important program for the working of the computer system. Okay. Next slide, you can see what is the difference between the kernel and OS. So there you can realize again what is the characteristics or the actual difference. So first difference is kernel is a core part of operating system, and operating system is a collection of software that manage computer hardware and resources. Where you can see, second point is kernel acts as an interface between software and hardware of the computer system. Kernel, it plays an important role in memory management, task management, process management, disk management. And kernel is a monolithic kernel, as well as a kernel is a microkernel, are the two types of the kernel. Monolithic and microkernel, that I will tell you afterwards. It is a big discussion is required for this monolithic kernel and microkernel. Okay, now share. So here I will stop. Okay. This is the some of the parts that we have seen in unit number one. I will close it. Now I will again come back to our unit number two. So here, architecture of the Unix system that you can see on your screen, the slide, architecture of the Unix system. So here we are focusing on kernel. We are also providing the overview of its architecture and outlining the basic concepts and structure essential for understanding the rest of the topic in the syllabus. Okay. Now I will move the slide. So this is the architecture of the Unix system. Is it visible to you, all of you? This is also a very important figure as far as unit number two is concerned. Okay. Is it visible to you? Clearly? Can you see the figure clearly? Yes. Okay. So this architecture of the Unix operating system. Now, इस architecture में और जो previous architecture था उसमें क्या difference है? So that architecture is the overview of the Unix operating system, where this is the block diagram of the system kernel. So here you can read in the line, caption is given to that figure is block diagram of the system kernel. Block diagram of the system kernel. And that is the system overview. This is the block diagram of the system kernel. So आपको मैं थोड़ा सा मैं purposely ये थोड़ा सा slowly आपको explain कर रहा हूँ, क्योंकि now you can see this is the one day is online, another day is offline. तो ये जो COVID-19 के कारण थोड़ी सी हमें this is a disturbance actually. It's called as a disturbance in teaching and learning process. So what is important here to understand the concept clearly. So that's why slowly you also try to understand the concept. आज अभी आप online कर रहे हैं, कल आपको offline आना है, okay? So tomorrow we will start from this point. That what is the block diagram of the system kernel, and what is the overview of the Unix operating system. तो जब कभी भी आपको ओवरव्यू या फिर आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द यूनिक्स सिस्टम आएगा तो आपको यही ड्रॉ करना पड़ेगा. अगेन देर इज अ what you can say, the constraint of the marking. अगर आपको चार मार्क के लिए क्वेश्चन आया तो आपको वो पहली फिगर जो है वो निकालनी पड़ेगी, आपको अगर आठ मार्क के लिए क्वेश्चन आया तो आपको ये फिगर निकालनी पड़ेगी. सो दिस इज द कंस्ट्रेंट ऑफ द मार्किंग स्कीम. क्वेश्चन कितने मार्क को पूछा है उस हिसाब से आपको ये आर्किटेक्चर ड्रॉ करना पड़ेगा. ओके, गॉट इट? सो दिस इज द ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द सिस्टम कर्नल, ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द सिस्टम कर्नल. But my dear student, this block diagram of system kernel and that layer architecture, that circular architecture of the Unix operating system are exactly one and same. Only the difference is that this block diagram of the system kernel is explained in detail. And that is the overview. That architecture of the Unix operating system, jo circle tha, layer 1, layer 0, layer 1, layer 2, layer 3. That one was the overview. But this is the actual block diagram of the system kernel. So, aapne title kya dikhaya hai? Dekho, abhi yahan pe title aap dekh sakte hai. This is the architecture of the Unix operating system. But below it is written, this is the block diagram of the system kernel. Means what? जैसे आपने अभी शुरू में मैंने कहा आपको कि कर्नल एंड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम आर वन एंड सेम. सो इट इज अ ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ द सिस्टम कर्नल. सो दैट मीन्स इट इज अ ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. दैट इज वन एंड सेम. कर्नल इज सिमिलर टू दैट ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. सो यू ऑब्जर्व द फिगर क्लियरली. वेर लेट मी स्टार्ट the explanation of the speaker with some levels are there. So you can see the mouse pointer. The first level is user level. So dekho yahan pe maine point out kiya hai user level. Kernel. Then second is the kernel level. यूजर लेवल यहाँ पे है, उसके नीचे कर्नल लेवल है. कर्नल लेवल में आप देख सकते हैं कि वहाँ पे वेरियस ब्लॉक्स आपको दिखाई देंगे. या यहाँ तक कर्नल लेवल का जो ब्लॉक्स है वो आप देख रहे हैं. और कर्नल लेवल के पीछे इमीडिएटली आफ्टर कर्नल लेवल देर इज अ हार्डवेयर लेयर और हार्डवेयर लेवल. नाउ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट क्लियरली दैट दिस फिगर एंड दैट फिगर आर सेम. Only this is a block diagram and that one was a layer architecture. This is also the layer architecture. Yahan pe bhi aapne layer dekha hai ki pehle kya tha user level. So that is what innermost layer or outermost layer? Anyone can reply? User level is innermost layer or outermost layer? Outermost layer. Very good. So and then comes the kernel level. And then comes the hardware layer. So hardware layer is the innermost layer. Okay. Hardware layer is the innermost layer. So that gives the clear comparison of this architecture and that overview of the Unix operating system. Now, dear students, see, you just focus on the figure where many things are shown in this block diagram. The very important part is that, now I will start from the beginning, user level. Okay. So user level is what? User level where the user programs are available. User can type his or her program there with the help of editor. Like, for example, you want to write a C program, C++ program, Python program, Java program, shell program. So all this comes at this user level. Okay. Got it? So user can perform the user level instruction and data, as well as I can say the user level functions. Okay. All these things can be written or can be available with the user level. So where here a first block of this figure is shown, that is what? Libraries. What is the meaning of this libraries? What is the meaning of this library? What is this library? What is this library? What is this library block? Huh? Anyone can reply. Yes, Pratik Oza. Yes, Oza. Pratik Oza can reply. What is the use of this library? Pratik, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What is this library block? What is a library block here?
Libraries are one or more files that together perform a specific function.
Okay. So that is available there. No? That means the library files are available there.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now here, Siddhant is also saying that it is a predefined system function which we can use in our program. Correct? Both these Pratik and Siddhant has given a correct answer. See, dear student. These libraries are available at user level. जैसे मैंने कहा शुरू में कि user level में user instruction and user data, as well as user function. So what is this function? The user can use the library files or library functions to write his program. जैसे हम करते हैं कि yesterday.io.h, yesterday.lib.h, yes or no? So we are including the header files, library files. So we are using the printf scanf. So in shell program we are using the echo and read. So what is this? This is actually the libraries. This is actually the system function or system files which are already available there, and we as a user making the use of that files to write our program. So that's why the libraries, this block comes at user level. ये आपको मतलब why the library comes at the user level, so you must justify it comes at the user level because user can make the help of that library to write his or her own program. करते हैं ना हम library function use करके हमारा खुद का program write करते हैं. So that's why the library comes at the user level. Okay, clear this point? And now you can see, okay, so there is a one more word, that is trap is shown. Trap, I will explain what is meant by trap. Okay, so the trap, and this is pointing towards two things. So this is pointing toward the first arrow, and this trap is also pointing toward the second arrow. Okay. And immediately after this trap, you can see the level is changing. So kernel level is starting. What is the meaning of this? The meaning of this is that anybody want to say something? Okay, see. So immediately when the system call is encounter, immediately when the system call is encounter, then the user level is switched to kernel level. Okay, immediately when the system call is encounter, so you can use the system call in your program. Okay, try to understand the point clearly. Aapne program likha hai और आपने आपके प्रोग्राम में सिस्टम कॉल यूज किया है, हम यूज कर सकते हैं, सिस्टम कॉल का यूज हम हमारे प्रोग्राम में कर सकते हैं, बट इमीडिएटली व्हेन द सिस्टम कॉल इज एनकाउंटर देन देर इज अ स्विच, देर इज अ स्विच फ्रॉम यूजर लेवल टू कर्नल लेवल. ओके, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज शोन देयर द फर्स्ट ब्लॉक इन द कर्नल लेवल इज सिस्टम कॉल इंटरफेस. ओके, सिस्टम कॉल. So the question is now, how we can switch to kernel level? How we can switch to kernel level? So we can switch to kernel level whenever, यहाँ पे arrow दिखाया देखो, user program is having a interface between system call. So user ने अगर उसके program में system call का use किया, then it is directly switch to kernel level. और यहाँ पे भी एरो दिखाया है, लाइब्रेरी फाइल्स में अगर सिस्टम कॉल का यूज हो गया देन इट इज डायरेक्टली स्विच टू द कर्नल लेवल. ओके, सो कंपाइलर, कंपाइलर, यू नो द कंपाइलर, वंस वी राइट द प्रोग्राम एंड वी आर ट्राई टू एग्जीक्यूट इट, द कंपाइलर कंपाइल द प्रोग्राम, इंटरप्रिटर इंटरप्रिट द प्रोग्राम, इंटरप्रिटर कन्वर्ट द हाई लेवल प्रोग्राम इन टू द मशीन लेवल प्रोग्राम. सो whenever it encounters the system call, okay, then it directly switch from user level to kernel level. Okay, is this point is clear to everybody? So you must know when a user switch from user means a operating system, na? It switch from user level to kernel level. So whenever a system call is encountered, then it immediately switch from user level to kernel level. Okay, is this point is clear to everybody? Okay, so now you can see here in this figure, it gives the block diagram of the kernel and it shows the various modules and their relationship. Now there are relationship, various modules are there and the relationship of that modules is also shown. Okay, now in particular you can see there is a file system. Now the system called interface, immediately after that there is a file subsystem on my left hand side. There is a file subsystem, and on the right hand side there is a process control subsystem. Process control subsystem. Okay, and this process control subsystem is again having a three sub modules. First one is inter-process communication. Second one is scheduler, and third one is memory management. Okay, so two very important blocks are there: file subsystem and process control subsystem. Okay, and then first of all I will explain all the blocks and then we will discuss on each and every block. Then after file system you can see there is a module buffer cache, buffer cache, and after this buffer cache there is a device driver, device driver. This device driver is again having two sub blocks. First one is character device driver, character, and second one is block device driver. Okay, yahan tak aapko samajh mein aaya hai, character device driver and block device driver. So this is a device driver block, device driver block and file subsystem block. Ye dono block ke beech mein बफर कैचे का ब्लॉक आपको ड्रॉ करना है. एंड इमीडिएटली आफ्टर द डिवाइस ड्राइवर एंड ऑल्सो हियर अ प्रोसेस कंट्रोल सब सिस्टम, वी आर हैविंग अ हार्डवेयर कंट्रोल, वी आर हैविंग अ हार्डवेयर कंट्रोल. ओके, गॉट इट. एंड हियर अ कर्नल लेवल एंड्स, hardware control, and here the kernel level ends. So altogether you can see there is how many blocks are there in kernel level. So So there is a system called interface. There is a file subsystem, process control subsystem, buffer cache, device driver, and hardware control. So how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six blocks are there in the kernel level. And now, after kernel level, there is a hardware level that contains only one block, that is a hardware, actual hardware present on the system. Okay. So this is a brief explanation about this architecture or the block diagram of the kernel. My again appeal to everybody is that everybody should fix the architecture or this block diagram of the system kernel in your mind. Fix means you have to create a picture, as it is a picture in your mind, that what is the architecture of the Unix system. How many blocks are there? How many levels are there? What each and every level contains? Okay. So that things are very important to remember. Okay. So user level is there. User level is having user program. User can write the program. User can create the program with the help of library files. And whenever the system call is encountered in the user program or in the library files, then the user level is switched to the kernel level. In kernel level, we are having a system called interface. Then we are having a file subsystem. We are having a process control subsystem. Then we are having a buffer cache. Then we are having a device driver. Device driver is having a character device driver and the block device driver. Similarly, the process control subsystem is having an inter-process communication, scheduler, memory management, and then device driver and process control subsystem is interfacing with hardware control. After this level, we are having an actual hardware level. There is the actual hardware is available. Clear? Clear to everybody? This is the block diagram of the kernel. Here we are focusing on the kernel. Okay, clear to everybody? So now the next point is the actual detailed explanation about this. Here. Now actually that figure, the block diagram is this. The block diagram of the kernel, it gives the block diagram of the kernel showing various modules and their relationship with each other. Okay, that point is clear. In particular, it shows the file subsystem on the left and the process control subsystem on the right, the two major components of the kernel. So what are the two major components of the kernel? First one is the file subsystem and second one is the process control subsystem. File subsystem and second one is the process control subsystem. Okay. The diagram serves as a useful logical view of the kernel. Although in practice, the kernel deviates from the model because some module interact with the internal operation of others. Now the figure shows there are three levels. First one is the user level, kernel level, hardware level. Okay. Now system call and the library interface represent the border between user program and the kernel. So this is the library and the system call interface. Talking about these two, that are nothing but that represent the border between user program and the kernel. Now, what is the system called? So see, many times we discussed in the past also, system called is what? System called is like an ordinary function call in C program. And libraries map this function call to the primitives needed to enter the operating system. Okay. So it is an ordinary.
Just a minute.
So a system call is like an ordinary C function. So मैंने कहा था बहुत बार आपको कि what is a system call? System call is like an ordinary C function. And libraries are what? It maps the function call to primitives needed to enter the operating system. Okay? So there are many system calls. Like a fork is a system call. Is used to create the child process. Execl is the system call, which is used to execute the file. Then exit is a system call, which is used to terminate the process. Like this, there are many system calls that we are going to learn all these system calls here only. And the libraries are nothing but the library files or the library functions, which actually used to primitives. Whatever we are writing, like suppose in C language we are writing the printf, then that printf actually supported by the library function hash include stdio.h header file. Okay, because printf is a library function. So similarly, there are many library functions which are supported by many primitives which are needed to enter the operating. Now, assembly language programs may invoke system call directly without the system call library. And programs frequently use other libraries such as standard input-output library to provide more sophisticated use of system call. That means whatever I am saying. The libraries are linked with other programs at compile time and thus a part of user program for the purpose of discussion. Okay. So whatever I am saying. As you can see, the figure partitions the set of system calls into those that interact with the file subsystem and those that interact with the process control subsystem. Okay. So now here actually we are doing a partition. We are actually doing a partition where you can see two main parts. First one is the file subsystem. And second one is the process control subsystem. Process control subsystem. What is this? This is actually the two main partitions, file subsystem and the process control subsystem. Among these two partitions or two blocks, the total system calls are divided. All our system calls are divided into two blocks. Okay. Now, file subsystem manages the file. Allocating the file space, administrating the free space, controlling access to the file, and retrieving the data for user. Okay, so second sentence is very important for file subsystem. The file subsystem manages the file, allocating the file space, administrating the free space, controlling access to the files, and retrieving the data for the user. Means this block is actually responsible for all file related operations. Okay? All file related operations. So what it is doing, the file subsystem, you can notice there, it is actually used to manage the files. The file subsystem is used to manage the files, used to allocating the file space, administrating the free space, controlling the access to the files, and retrieving the data for the user. Okay, so aapko question aayega, what is the use of file subsystem? What the function performed by file system? So the function which are performed by the file subsystems are, you can read here, the file second block, second line you can read, the file subsystem manages the file, allocating the file space, administrating the free space, and controlling access to the file and retrieving the data for the user. So manages the file means what? Manages the file. What do you mean by manages the file? What do you mean by manages the file? Can anybody tell me what is meant by managing the file? Kindly respond. What is meant by managing the file? See, managing the file means you can create the file, you can delete the file, you can rename the file, you can copy the file. Yes or no? All these operations, you can modify the file. All these operations, you can open the file, you can close the file. So all these operations are nothing but managing the file. Aap create karte, aap rename karte, delete karte, modify karte, open karte, close karte, copy karte. All these nothing but the managing the file. All these operations are performed by the file subsystem. Second, aap dekh sakte yahan pe, file subsystem allocating the file space. Allocating the file space ka matlab kya hai ki jab aap file create karte hai, to use kuch na kuch space chahiye. 1 kilobyte, 4 kilobyte, 6 kilobyte, 1 GB, 10 GB, 1 MB, 10 MB, 20 MB. So ye file space dene ka kaam kon karega? Who is responsible for allocating the file space? The file subsystem is responsible for allocating the file space. Okay, very important. And then second one is what? Third one, administrating the free space. Free space ka matlab kya hai ki now whenever you are creating the file and saving the file, so where it is saved, it is saved on the secondary storage device, hard disk pe save rehti hai. So hard disk pe aapki file aapne save ki, then whatever the remaining space is there, that is administered or that is controlled by the file subsystem, administrating the free space efficiently. Then fourth one is controlling access to the file. So whenever we are opening the file, we want to read the file, write the file. Okay, then that controlling will be done by the file subsystem. Whenever we want to retrieve the data for the user, that will be done by the file subsystem. Okay, so yahan pe PPT mein maine matlab ek hi line likhi hai, lekin this line is having a very big meaning, that what the job done by the file subsystem. File subsystem normally perform the operation like it manage the file, that is open the file, read the file, write the file, create the file, delete the file, modify the file, rename the file, copy the file. All these operation will be done by the file subsystem. Then it gives the file space, it gives some space
in the file system, that is nothing but the allocating the file space. Whatever the remaining free space is there, that will be administered by the file subsystem. It controls the access to the file. Okay. Now, controlling the access to the file means read access, write access, execute access. All this access will be controlled by the file subsystem. And also, it is retrieving the data for the user. Okay. Whenever we are retrieving the data, that will be done by the file subsystem. Okay. Clear to everybody what I am saying? Is it clear to everybody? Now, third sentence you can read here. A process interacts with the file system via a specific set of system calls. Okay, now the system call comes here. So, शुरू में आपने कहा था कि ये जो सब सिस्टम कॉल्ड है, that figure I will again brought to your notice. I will go back and this is the figure. So, here you can notice the system call is some system calls are for file subsystem, some system calls are for process control subsystem. तो हमें क्या अभी find out करना है कि file system का काम क्या था मैंने बताया. It manages the file. It allocates the file space. It administrating the free space. It is controlling the access to the file. And last one is, it is retrieving the user data. Okay? It retrieving the data for user. So, ये सब काम करने के लिए ये सब काम करने के लिए सिस्टम कॉल्स अवेलेबल है. सो दैट इज नथिंग बट व्हाट आर द सिस्टम कॉल्स व्हिच आर अवेलेबल फॉर परफॉर्मिंग द फाइल सब सिस्टम एक्टिविटी. सो नाउ आई विल टेल यू व्हाट आर द सिस्टम कॉल्स. सो यू कैन रीड हियर. अ प्रोसेस कैन इंटरैक्ट विद द फाइल सिस्टम वाया स्पेसिफिक सेट ऑफ सिस्टम कॉल्स सच एज ओपन. ओपन इज अ सिस्टम कॉल व्हिच इज यूज्ड टू ओपन द फाइल फॉर रीडिंग और राइटिंग. Close, read, write, stat. Stat is the statistic. That is normally query the attributes of the file. CHO, change the record of who owns the file. And CHMOD, change the access permission of the file. So these are some of the system calls which are specifically designed or specifically used for the file subsystem. So, ab tak aapne kya dekha? File subsystem, how many system calls are responsible? What is the job of file system? What is the job of file system? It is used to manage the file. It is used to control the access of the file. It is used to retrieve the data for the user. It is used to allocate the file space. And it is actually controlling the free space. So how it will doing all these things? The file subsystem is making the use of system call. So, कौन से सिस्टम कॉल्स है वो? So, the system calls are, you can see, the system calls are open, then close, read, write, stat, chown, chmod. These are all are system calls which are related with the file subsystem. Got it? Now, what I will do? Your time is finished, so I will stop here, and tomorrow in the lecture we will continue with our remaining part of unit number 2. Okay, now still then go to the LMS and view the attendance of this lecture. Okay, probably this lecture was of OOPS, no, object oriented program. So my attendance was not scheduled there on LMS. So I will do, I will share the link of the Google form where you can fill the today's attendance. Okay, last time aapko maine jab online tab hamara ek Google form tha, to Google form mein maine aapko link provide karunga, wahan pe aap aaj ki attendance mark karo. And after this, in the next session we are having a practical, so again use the same link. Okay, I will not forward the link now. Use the same link. Those who are having the OSA practical, use this link for joining the practical session in the afternoon. Till then, now I will end the session. Thank you very much. Good day.